Hey everyone, in today's video, we will show you how to edit a 3D tour using Zillow's My 3D Homes dashboard on a desktop. I'm Nick at Hauseit. If you have any questions about this video, comments, suggestions, please don't hesitate to leave us a comment below or send us an email to team@hauseit.com, and our website is hauseit.com. The spelling is below. So here we are on the dashboard for Zillow My 3D Homes. Now, in order to get here, you do need to create an account, and I happen to be logged into the Hauseit agent account on the Zillow platform. So the dashboard will show you all of the 3D tours that you've done in the past. So you can see we've done several since they rolled this out, and all of them are published, which means that the listings on Zillow do actually show the tour. So here is an example. We'll click on 224 West 18th Street. It's going to initially take us to the owner view, but in order to see what it looks like publicly, go ahead and click on public view right here. And you'll see here on the listing, it should have the 3D tour down towards the left, just below the photos. There you have it. So that's pretty much the end goal. You can also take the tour link using share, and you can copy the link and you can add it to your StreetEasy listing if you are here in New York City. And you could also just simply take the tour URL and share it or send it to clients, buyers, buyer's agents, friends, family, whoever, just using the URL below. So that's pretty much the end goal. But today we're going to actually show you how to edit a tour. And the reason why we need to edit a tour is because after you take the footage, it's never normally perfect. For example, here we have a tour. This is the foyer. But there's no buttons, right? We can't really go anywhere, so it's not really super useful. Furthermore, as you can potentially see here, some of the images themselves could perhaps be optimized in a sense that, like, for example, this one here, the laundry, not the prettiest shot the way it was like that, so we could potentially modify it and maybe make this the actual image that appears here on the right, so that the actual thumbnails are more useful. So we're gonna go ahead and do that. So we'll X out of the tour, click on the three dots and click on edit tour. Now it's gonna start, I believe, where you filmed the first footage. And depending on how you're doing it, sometimes you start somewhere that's not the entrance. And in some cases it does make sense to start the tour, say here, because it looks great with all the windows. But just for training purposes, we're gonna start at the entrance of the apartment, just so it's a bit more intuitive. So the first thing we can think about is, does the thumbnail look good? Currently, the thumbnail appears to be sort of like this, perhaps like this. So it's all right. It's definitely better than if it were like this. Sometimes the 3D camera will take something very ugly like this and you'd want to modify it. So I think in this case, it's pretty good, but we could potentially try to optimize it a little bit and maybe do something like this. So the center field of vision actually shows something, and on the left and right, it's not too blown out or distorted due to the wide angle. So if we like the way this looks, we would click on set default view, and we would hit the set for set this panorama as default view. And then you'll see this pop up here. So at this point, what we'll do then is we'll start adding arrows. So this here is the bathroom. So we'll go ahead and, for example, find bathroom, which is somewhere down here. There it is. And go ahead and click the plus arrow, which will bring up the arrow to the bathroom. Now you can drag here and move it around. So obviously we want to move it to the bathroom entrance. Go ahead and hit save. So now if we're in the foyer and click on bathroom, it's going to take us into the bathroom. And then once we're here, we'll do that same analysis with the cover image. I think that shows a little bit too much cabinet, so we could potentially reset this, maybe with something like this. So we'll hit set default, click set, and there you go. So if we turn around, it looks like it's put an arrow into the hallway, which should be correct, but we don't have an arrow back to the foyer. And so we can click plus on foyer, go ahead and add that in, and hit save. So if we go back to the foyer, now we can add the hallway. Now sometimes we have several hallways and it's a bit confusing which hallway to use. But in this case, I recall from taking the tour and the proximity that this hallway was most likely captured before the one over here. Therefore, we can conclude that this one is the right hallway. So we'll go ahead and put that there and hit save. And we also need to go into the bedroom. So we'll hit the plus right here and hit save. Now, the other thing we want to do perhaps is to set this as the default view when somebody first clicks on the tour. We don't want to confuse people. If they get lost, it's pretty unhelpful. So this may be an appropriate starting point, the entrance of the apartment. So in order to set that as the default view or shot for the floor, click on Edit Details and go ahead and check the box First Panorama for this floor and hit Save. So then we can continue and move forward. So let's go in the bedroom, and looks like we have an arrow here that is a bit of an odd placement. I mean, where does this go? There's no view over there. Presumably this is the view shot we took from the window, which means it probably should not be here. In fact, it should probably be linked to this bedroom shot, which is a little bit closer to the window itself. So if we go back to the bedroom, the first bedroom shot, we know that we should delete the view. We can do that by clicking Edit Arrows, then click on the view, and click on Delete. So that is gone. And quickly, while we're in bedroom, let's just turn around and make sure the arrow lets us go back, and it's not here. So let's go ahead and add an arrow back to the foyer. It seems appropriate. Go ahead and hit save, and we'll go back to the bedroom. So let's click on that second bedroom button, and here the view arrow looks correct. So if we click on view, looks pretty good to me. And it looks like the thumbnail is pretty good too. Now this appears to be a link to the other bedroom, and we can tell by clicking on Edit Arrows. And if we click on it, it shows me what it is. So it actually looks like it's still the correct bedroom, but obviously it's not the correct placement. So if we turn around, it looks like this bedroom arrow is the one to the shot that's closer to the window. So to me, I'd like to delete this arrow. So I'll click Edit Arrows, I'll click on this one, and I will click Delete. X that out. Sometimes the prompts can get a bit annoying, but just go ahead and X that out before you proceed. So let's turn around, click on bedroom, and it looks correct. So it takes us to the bedroom, and then this one is to the next bedroom location, back to the foyer, and now we can proceed down the hallway. So at this point, let's scroll down here and see what our options are. Presumably, there is another hallway. Looks like there are two, so not sure which one to use, although I have a feeling we probably want to use this one. So I'll go ahead and click plus there, add the hallway, and I'll just quickly turn around and make sure that I can see the correct arrows. The bathroom is here. We may want to add foyer, and we may also want to even add a link to the bedroom. So we can put the foyer there. And the bedroom, remember it's the bedroom shot that is the one furthest from the window. Put that over there. And that way we have some visibility. Now, if we're being a perfectionist, maybe we don't want these arrows to overlap, so we can slightly move over the bathroom arrow. Go ahead and hit save, and we'll turn back around. So let's go to the next hallway. And you'll note that when we're in the hallway, we always want to take a shot that is adjacent to doors. And that way, it nicely integrates with the arrows. It doesn't confuse anyone. So the first thing I notice is I go back, and we don't have access to that first hallway shot. So I'm gonna go ahead and add that. Note that we don't need to add the bathroom here, because presumably you'd wanna first go to the next hallway before you have access to the other arrows. So let's click on hallway, and it looks like they've been so kind as to correctly place the bedroom arrow for the master. So let's click on that, and it looks like we went into the right place. And it seems like the hallway was also done correctly, which is great. So now that we're in the bedroom, looks like there's a missing link to the bathroom. So let's go ahead and scroll to the right down here and find the master bath. There it is. Go ahead and hit save, and let us go into the bathroom. thumbnail looks all right, and we'll need to add the arrow to go back into the master bedroom. So we'll hit save. And at this point, I believe we have a view shot and we have an additional shot from the bedroom from the other side of the room. So we can go ahead and add that second bedroom shot. There we are, correct. And the view, which looks good as well. Now in the thumbnail, you can see there's a bit of wall, like we kind of have it like that. Perhaps we want to make it a little bit less wall, something like this, just so it is more of a view shot than anything else. So that we fix that, we hit set default view and we hit set. Then we'll turn around and make sure we can get back to where we came from. So looks like sometimes it jumps, so it clicked back pretty quickly there. Let's try that again. So bedroom looks good. Now we need to get back to the other side of the bedroom. So we'll put that arrow there. And from here, we have the hallway and we have the bedroom to the right. So everything looks pretty good. So let's proceed. And now it looks like we're about to enter the living area. So hopefully we have some nice shots from the living room and such. Let's take a look. They appear to be over here. So let's go ahead and venture to guess that it might be this one. So let's click add that, click save, click there, and it does appear to be correct. Now we want to add the hallway back here so we can actually go back to where we were. Go ahead and put that there, hit save, and here we are. So from here, it's kind of confusing. There's like view and dining room and all this crazy stuff going on. So we should probably just start fresh, to be honest. It's too confusing. So I'm gonna go ahead and just delete all these arrows and just start again to save time. So I deleted that. I'm gonna delete this one as well. Deletes, perfect. Now, the easiest one appears to be the kitchen. Let's go ahead and try to find the kitchen. So we got to scroll down here, and here is the kitchen. So let's add the kitchen arrow, hit save. Kitchen looks pretty good. Now we probably want to be able to get back to that first living room shot that we're familiar with, which is over there. These two, suppose we don't have to delete them. We want to see where they are. We can click edit, we can click dining room, and then we can kind of get a sense for what the view might be in here, and it does appear to be correct. So what I might do here is I'm going to delete this living room arrow because it's not really pointing anywhere helpful, and we'll rely on these two arrows for mobility. So once we click dining room, here we are. We want to make sure A, that we can get back to that living room shot that we had originally, which appears to be correct. And I suppose now it's clear that we need to add dining room arrow here. So let us click dining room, add that in, hit save, and we're back at the dining room. We have kitchen access and living room access. So from here, we can test these arrows out, go to the living room, looks to be correct. We have access to the dining room. I suppose it's fine to have kitchen here, just something to let us go back around the corner. But here I'm a bit confused. So let me figure out what view this is. It appears to be a view going out the window, but I have a feeling it's from this window. Not 100% sure, but let's check that out. So let's click on the other living room, and it does appear to be the case that the view we were looking at definitely is from that window. So let's go back to this corner, and we should therefore delete the view because we would get to the view from the next location. So I'm going to delete the view, and then this living room arrow, I'm going to click edit, and I'm going to move it over a little bit to the right. Now from here, obviously, we have the view, and that is correct. So the view looks good. I believe that living room is correct, that previous vantage point. This here is a bit confusing. I think this living room shot is going to take us way over there. So we could probably just go ahead and delete that. And this, let's go back. So from the dining room, I suppose we should delete the view shot because again, you probably want to click on the next living room vantage point first. So let's delete the view And let's go back to living room and then the view. So from here, just to confirm, living room will take us over here, dining room right here, and the living room to the right. So that all appears to be fairly good. From this corner, we have dining room, living room, living room. I would probably move this a little more to the right just to avoid confusion. And perhaps as well, the dining room one, we can just spread them out so it's not so cluttered. So the living room, I'll move it to the left a little bit. And that might actually be sufficient. So we'll just quickly do a test, click on living room. And look, it appears to be the case that that is not a good decision, in my opinion, because it's just too far away. So if we go back to that corner, we should probably go ahead and remove living room, because that just takes us way too far. User should go to the dining room first before clicking on that far end of the living room. So that's pretty much it. We've essentially done the interior. Now, I typically like to do the 3D tours and go a little bit further and take some exterior shots. And that by that, I mean like the entrance of the building. So for example, here we have one outside the building, which is in Battery Park. So perhaps then we have an arrow that goes into the building. Now, I wasn't able to take a lobby shot in this particular building. So instead, the next arrow would take us to the foyer or hallway of the actual floor where the apartment is. So I found that and I click save. And if I click on hallway, you can see that it actually takes us into the hallway where the entrance to the apartment is. So from here, we're gonna wanna add foyer, which is the actual entrance to the apartment. And for good measure, somewhere in the opposite direction, I can probably add the entrance to the building. So let's go back to the entrance, hallway, foyer, boom, we're in the apartment. So this is pretty much done. Now, I can't guarantee that it's perfect. What I typically like to do is to test it out on the listing as well with a fresh set of eyes just to make sure everything looks good. And if there is a mistake, you can easily update it back in My 3D Homes. So if you're done editing, you can go ahead and click back. You could also, if you're more aggressive and optimistic and you're not tired like I am, you can click view and you can check it out and see what it actually looks like. So click back, you're back on your dashboard. And then whenever the time comes for you to publish the listing, you would click add tour address to actually put the address onto the tour and you would publish it onto Zillow. So we hope you found this video helpful. I'm Nick at Hauseit. If you have any questions or comments, please don't hesitate to leave one down below in the comment section of the video. If you like the video, please upvote. We'd greatly appreciate that. We'd love to have you as a subscriber as well. And if there's anything else we can help you with, send us an email, team@hauseit.com. If you're here in the city and you are a seller, you'd like to save money on commissions or save money when you're buying, we can help you with that too. I'm Nick at Hauseit. Thanks so much, and we'll see you on the next video.